Let's see one more example of inverting amplifier using op-amp. For this, I'll type COEP VLAB in Google. I'll get this link. So I'll just click it. So in that, I have already been logged in. So my name is there. Now I am clicking this electronics and communication. There, I will select hybrid electronics lab. So if you see the list of experiments here, you'll find in the last design and simulate inverting and non-inverting operational amplifier. So we'll click it. Now here AM theory, everything is given. We'll see the simulation. Okay, it says start the simulator. So here you can observe that an example here, two practicals are there, inverting and non-inverting. We'll see one by one. So here you can see a feedback resistor is there in the inverting terminal, and then input is given. So we'll have to select certain values, and accordingly we will see the simulation. So let us select RF. I am selecting as, let's say, 500. This again I am selecting as 500. So it minus RF upon R1 will have the gain of minus 1 only. Okay, let's say I am selecting the input as 1 volt, and now I am just saying run. So output I am getting as minus 1 volt. As we know, the gain is, closed loop gain is minus RF upon R1, which gives us minus 1 value. When it is multiplied by 1, we get this. And see, they are out of phase. Input and output are out of phase. Let us increase the input voltage. I just increased it to 5 volt and I am running it. So I am getting the output voltage as minus 5 volt. And now see the increase in amplitude. So in this way, you can select as your the gain as you desire. Let us say I am selecting this gain as 1000. So it has given a range of 50 to 1000. So I have a possibility to select like this one. So, and let's say I am selecting input as 2 volt. So my gain will be now minus 1000 upon 500, minus 2, means minus 2. So I should get a minus 4 volt. So I am just running it. So I am getting minus 4, and accordingly there is a change in the input and output, new input and output you can see. Let's say I am changing the input now again to some 4 volt. Accordingly, the output should be minus 8 volt. See the change here, the input voltage now will be increased. So from this point we can see like this. And also you can see the 180 degree phase shift between input and output, which shows that it is acting as a inverting amplifier. So in this way you can have the virtual lab experience in the inverting amplifier.